In Charlotte, North Carolina, the stage is set for a pared-down Republican National Convention to kick off Monday.
Well, this is obviously not what we expected 2+ years ago.
While thousands aren't descending on the city as originally planned, a small number of delegates will vote in person Monday to renominate President Donald Trump.
Unlike the Democratic convention, where they had people all over the country zooming in or however they produced that, they are going to have the ritual roll call of the states. It's just going to be much smaller than usual.
The president is expected to travel to the Tar Heel state to address delegates, a move Dr. John Holder says sends a clear message regarding the ongoing coronavirus pandemic.
The Republican convention, by putting several hundred people in a room in Charlotte, is saying this is no big deal. So it's essentially a display of what they're going to argue is the administration's effectiveness in dealing with this.
Each night, nearly 20 convention speakers will appear by video from Washington and elsewhere, including former Ambassador Nikki Haley, Franklin Graham, and Melania Trump, who will speak Tuesday evening from the newly renovated Rose Garden.
I'm going to see a sharp contrast with what we saw this past week with the DNC. I think it's just going to be a mix of people telling their stories of what's worked.
While the president is expected to appear each night, it's believed he will make his formal acceptance speech from the White House on Thursday.
You've not only got to make the case against your opponent, you've got to make the case for yourself. So he can bash Joe Biden all he wants to, but he's got to make a positive, affirming case for his reelection.
The question remains if 2 weeks of primetime convention television will make a difference with American voters on November 3rd. Sarah Blake Morgan, The Associated Press.